think it's BS. Come on, man. No. Can you imagine making like the white-tailed deer your national animal and everyone's just like putting them on their walls? This is a national animal that you pick. Come on, like a bear. Right. That's a good national animal.
This one totally makes sense. Yeah.
These are reindeer,
like king of all deer.
They're not king of all deer. What is wrong with you? Hello and welcome to this episode of I Should Have Known, the trivia game show that can't be trusted. Each week, one of our quizmasters will present you with four facts about a topic, but one of those facts is a lie. And for this month, we are diving into the animal kingdom and exploring the wonderful creatures within. And today, our first quizmaster is Sups.
Hello.
And Sups is going to be presenting you with four national animals. So the national animals of four different countries, except one of the animals he presents is not the national animal of the country. So join me, Andy, and our other host, Tanner, in figuring out which one it is.
Well, let's start with the pub quiz question of the week. What is the national animal of Canada?
I kind of thought it would be a moose.
Probably a moose or a beaver.
I don't know.
Yeah, let's go with moose.
It's actually the other one.
Oh,
it's a beaver.
It is a beaver.
The beaver was given the official status as an emblem of Canada only in like 1975, but historically, because of the fur trade, beaver is very popular in Canada.
Yeah.
It's like, okay, Canada, sure.
Taking the beaver.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Okay.
Not as majestic as other animals maybe, but very distinctly Canadian.
Correct. All right. So country number one, Mongolia.
Mm.
The national animal of Mongolia is Przewalski's horse.
Okay.
Yep. Also known as Tach, Przewalski's horse is the only surviving wild horse species on the planet. Unlike domesticated horses, they have never been truly domesticated.
Mm-hmm.
And their sort of lineage goes back thousands of years. And of course, lots of legends, one of them being Genghis Khan rode a Tach as he conquered the world.
Yeah. I imagine like this big man on like a tiny horse. kind of entertaining.
That's very fitting as it's in Mongolia.
Yeah. This horse is typically smaller. It's about like 4 feet tall.
Oh.
I have heard this
before. I think I've
seen
that.
Yeah. I think I saw it in a zoo.
Maybe.
Something. A smaller horse.
Yeah. This horse is a symbol for strength and endurance.
Mm-hmm.
They can survive really harsh conditions.
They're hardy. Mm-hmm.
Yes. Mm-hmm. In Mongolia, especially in the semi-arid regions, the desert, the horse is actually related to the zebra and has a black stripe on its back.
Mm-hmm.
They usually live in a small cohesive family groups.
And you said it's wild.
Yes.
But there's no other wild ones.
Correct.
So the horses that run around America, like they weren't native there, right? They were brought there. And you're saying that, like, they're not wild. They must be feral then.
Right.
So they were domesticated and then they, like, got out?
Yeah. Got out. Yeah, correct.
Makes sense.
And at one point, this Przewalski's horse was declared extinct in the wild during the 1960s. But then the Chinese and the Mongolian government, they had conservation efforts, right?
Okay.
And they were reintroduced in their natural habitats. And now they're not endangered anymore.
Nice.
Wow, they must reproduce like crazy.
Yeah, they really force them to make more
rabbits.
More foals.
Okay, well, to start, a horse makes sense.
For Mongolia?
Yes, for the region in general, right? Mm-hmm. It's very flat. Many, many cultures coming from this region have centered around horses.
Right.
So like, okay, sure. The domesticated horse is native to this region.
Right.
That's where they were first domesticated, was in Central Asia.
So it makes sense.
Like, it's a very important animal.
Mm-hmm.
This other kind of horse, I think the horse exists. That's not the question. Is it the national animal, though?
Right. That's what the question is. Why wouldn't it be like something that we would think of first? You know, I wouldn't guess that it was the horse. So
that just says so much about you that you're like, I obviously would be able to guess it the first try.
Yeah.
And the fact that I didn't means that like they're
Sups
trying to
faking it.
Or it's a fake, or they're trying to surprise me.
The Mongolian government thought of me and they're like, what is Tanner going to guess?
Yeah.
Wow.
So, I mean, like, it might not be.
Right.
But I don't really have enough information. And I also feel like I don't currently have any reason to doubt it.
Right. Is it the only country with this horse? Like you mentioned, China as well has helped reintroduce it. So like maybe Mongolia would have something that's more quintessentially Mongolian.
Mm.
But I don't really know that much about Mongolia, so.
To me, that is a very ridiculous thing to say because like it's extremely rare that an animal is only in one country. Like yeah, not every animal is a panda, border, okay? Like,
oh no, I can't go into China.
Yeah, right? Like, oh, I don't have my passport. I left it at home.
Oh no.
You know, so like that's silly true. To me, but like I kind of get what you're saying that we expect the national animal to be something emblematic.
Yeah.
I don't know if, like, is it on their money? Is it on right. their seal? Like, I don't know. It could be.
Right.
But for now, I'm, like, okay with it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to need to hear the other ones before I can really decide.
Okay. From Mongolia, let's go all the way to Greece. The national animal of Greece is dolphin.
Yeah.
So, Greece is home to two species of dolphin, the common dolphin and the bottlenose dolphin.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
If you look at Greek mythology, dolphins have been featured as far back as the Minoan times.
Mm.
There are a lot of legends associated with it.
Mm.
Dolphin represents themes of protection, guidance, and of course the sea. The Greek sailors and fishermen, they view dolphins as like a symbol of good luck and protection.
Okay.
Yeah. That
kind of makes sense.
Yeah. And they're playful and like smart. Like they like to swim with boats. So if you're seafaring people, then you would have quite a relationship with dolphins.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You're definitely a cetacean nerd. I would expect you to know this. And they live in the Mediterranean.
Right. Huh. Yeah.
Yeah.
Never really think of them there.
Yeah. I mean, that to me is like the surprise is like, okay, well, it makes sense that a very island nation, seafaring people would have a dolphin as their symbol.
Mm-hmm.
Why have I never heard of that before? I guess. Yeah. It's kind of like a little weird or like.
Very surprising.
Yeah, I definitely believe like there are plenty of myths about dolphins. Dolphins are an important cultural animal. It's their national symbol. I don't know.
Mm.
I'm kind of skeptical of that. I feel okay. like modern governments are like unlikely to pick an animal like a dolphin.
Oh.
I think they would see it as feminine.
Okay. Oh, you need like a strong
yeah.
thing you can rally patriotism behind or
yeah,
something.
Yeah, right? So like,
it's interesting.
I have to make a clarification though, which might add to your confusion Uh-oh. Or clarity.
Great.
Unlike a lot of countries where you talk about national animals, dolphin is not officially designated as the national animal of Greece. Like there are no, at least I couldn't find any government documents or government listing, but in Greece, they say that this is the national animal. And in general, Greek people agree that this is the national animal.
Oh, what?
So a lot it's of countries, national. That's something that I also discovered while doing research for
mm-hmm.
this,
mm-hmm.
is that in the internet, there are countries listed with, okay, they have a national bird, national insect,
mm-hmm.
national animal, national mm-hmm. trees, but not all countries have.
Right.
But then there is like a general acceptance of certain animals that while it's not maybe written in the constitution or written in some official document,
mm-hmm.
it's sort of accepted that this is our mm. national animal.
Oh, okay.
I don't like that.
It's not official.
Yeah, because then you could say anything. You mm-hmm. could make culturally anything could be your
You could
animal.
Make an argument for yeah. a lot of animals, yeah.
I don't like that. Maybe he can find a government document that said dolphin because it's not the dolphin.
Right. Maybe that's yeah. the lie. Hmm. It's so hard to believe that people even think of the dolphin as the national animal of Greece, though. You know? Because it's like, I don't know. I'm so much more likely to think of the national animal as a mammal or a bird. Well, I guess a land mammal or a bird for something that lives in the sea. But then you get back to the idea of like it's seafaring. They have lots of islands. So then that's where this comes in. Hmm. Seems pretty sketchy.
Yeah.
I guess we're halfway through. Yeah. I hear two more.
Okay. Then let's go to Zimbabwe. The national animal of Zimbabwe is the zebra.
Okay.
Okay.
One of Africa's most recognizable animals.
Right.
The zebra was adopted as the national animal of Zimbabwe in 1981. Zimbabwe has only one species of zebra, a type of plains zebra known as the Chapman's zebra. In Zimbabwe, zebras can be hunted and zebra skins may be exported from Zimbabwe without any restrictions because no special hunting permits are required because this is commonly available. And zebra is often one of the trophies people consider for their first African hunt.
Oh, wow.
Hmm.
When they go trophy hunting.
You're right.
Okay.
That's really interesting to make such a common animal your national animal because it sounds very surprising to me that you can hunt a national animal.
Right, exactly. Like, they're just shooting their national animal.
Yeah. Like, imagine if it was America. I mean, like, can I get an eagle license? I'm going to go shoot some eagles on my land.
Apparently, it's important for the conservation of it because there are right. so many of them.
I can imagine that's yeah. part of it.
Yeah, yeah. If you think of them as like deer, you mm-hmm. know, if the national animal was a super common animal like deer,
yeah.
you have to hunt them because like we don't have enough wolves to keep control of their populations. So
yeah.
Makes sense.
It's just very funny to me that you're like, yeah, come hunt our national animal. I don't know.
I mean, the Australians eat kangaroo meat. Right. And it's a national animal. They have yeah. it everywhere.
Okay. That's what I mean. Like the American concept of a right. national animal is kind of like the really emblematic one. And Zimbabwe with zebras, it makes sense that like they're everywhere. So mm. you think of Zimbabwe, you think of zebra.
I think it's BS. Come yeah. on, man. No. Can you imagine making like the white-tailed deer your national animal and everyone's just like putting them sure. on their walls? Yeah. I don't know. That's just silly to me. I think something else is their national animal.
Yeah.
Yeah, like it's not impossible, but like also there are zebras everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Like there are a lot of countries that have zebras.
Right.
So to be like, sorry, zebras ours is a little bit like, I don't know. Yeah. Why don't you pick a cooler animal?
So many to choose from. Come on.
I really want in the bonus cut you to tell the story of how a zebra rescued you.
Oh, no.
Tanner was rescued by a zebra once.
Oh, wow.
It was okay. very funny.
In Kenya?
It's in Tanzania.
Tanzania. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, I just find that kind of suspicious.
Yeah, because yeah. you think that it's not unique enough.
Yeah, like yeah. really, that's your animal?
Right.
Come on. Like a chicken.
Yeah.
Mm. So I don't know. That's sketchy.
Mm.
So, I don't know.
I'm suspicious of that. One more.
One more. Let's go to Finland. The national animal. It's a brown bear.
Ooh.
The scientific name, Ursus arctos.
Doesn't that just mean bear bear?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's Latin yes. for bear and Greek for bear.
Bear bear.
Bear bear. The brown bear is so important for Finland that they have over 200 different names to call a bear.
What?
Yes, in their language.
Okay.
The brown bears of Finland are very unique and they're only found in the northern parts of the country.
Mm-hmm.
So there are some legends. There was like a terrible drought in the Sami community and mm-hmm. they were deprived of food and meat. The brown bears, they were watching this event. And one of the brown bear showed up and he said, listen, you don't have any food to eat. Why don't you kill me and eat my meat?
Eat my flesh so that you may survive.
And the Sami people, they were so overwhelmed with such a generous offer. So, of course, they killed the bear. They fed all the children. Everybody survived. And as a way of showing respect to the deceased bear, they arranged its bones in the same order as they existed in the body, except the skull. They hung the skull on trees, believing that the soul of the bear would reside there and bless them with peace and harmony.
Mm.
Okay.
So convenient that the bear came up and said,
yeah,
eat
yeah.
me.
That's so nice. Yeah. Yeah. I give you a free pass to eat me. It's fine.
Nice story.
So yeah, this one is like, this is a national animal that you pick. Come on, like a bear. Right. That's a good national animal,
it's
right?
It's formidable. You know? It's yeah. very, very majestic.
Right.
Sure. This one totally makes sense. Yeah.
Feels kind of familiar. Like, yeah, bear.
Yeah, European brown bear.
I mean, but at the same time, isn't that Russia's animal? And you know how Finns feel about Russia.
Yeah, you don't want neighboring countries to have the same national animal.
But I mean, I guess it also makes sense because that's where they live.
Yeah, right.
The only other animal that I could think of as being emblematic of Finland would be like a reindeer.
Yeah, that's exactly what I would think.
But I don't think that is one.
That's really hard because I think it would be more likely to have reindeer as the national animal.
No way. You want to put a deer on your...
Yeah, because they're so unique. Like, there's... Brown bears are, like, very widespread. Reindeer are not. So I think that that's where they would go. They would go with the more unique one.
Nah. Bear's better than a reindeer.
Yeah, I mean, it's not like you're picking animals for a battle or something.
Reindeer are so twerpy.
Yeah.
Like...
Yeah.
You did an entire episode on reindeer one year.
I know.
So yeah. You know how like...
I would make it my national animal.
Wow. Okay, so we heard the four animals, but one of them is not the national animal of the country that you mentioned. Before we take our guess, can you repeat the country and the animals for us?
Yes. Number one, Mongolia, Przewalski's horse. Number two, Greece, dolphin. Number three, Zimbabwe, zebra. Number 4, Finland brown bear. One of these combinations is not correct.
All right. They're all kind of hard to believe. I actually think the Mongolian one's the easiest to believe.
The horse. Yeah. Right?
I could think of some other animals it could be, but compared to the other three, that sounds the most believable.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm really stuck on this reindeer thing for Finland.
Nah, you shouldn't be. Yeah. I feel like the horse and the bear I'm the most like okay with. I don't like this dolphin thing.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like if it's not official, it's not a national animal.
Mm-hmm.
So then maybe that's the lie.
Yeah.
But why would he say that then?
Right.
I think it's probably the zebra.
Uh-huh.
He's just being like, you guys don't know shit about African countries. So I'm just going to say a random animal.
Right.
And yeah, you're not going to know.
And then Zimbabwe, you know it's an African country, yeah. But you don't actually know any facts about it.
Yeah.
Mm.
And then just being like, we shoot our national animal. Like, I don't know, man.
That should be a red flag.
That's super weird. Yeah. Yeah. I think it's that one.
Okay. I think it's the reindeer.
You're really stuck on the reindeer.
Yep. I'm definitely going with Finland. I think it's not the bear. It's some other animal. And I'm willing to bet it's the reindeer.
All right.
Okay. So let's start with Mongolia.
Mm-hmm.
The Przewalski's horse. It is indeed the national mm-hmm. animal
All right.
of Mongolia. For Greece, dolphin is indeed mm-hmm. the national animal.
Or as close as they can get to a national animal.
Yes, the closest that you can get. I didn't find any other source that contested this idea mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. that this isn't the national animal. You picked Zimbabwe.
The zebra.
The zebra. And you picked the
Finland.
Bear. Andy tried to convince you. Yet you didn't want to be convinced.
Mm-hmm. Are you surprised?
I don't know why, where he got that idea from and then was just like, yep.
I gave you such a nice story for the brown bear.
Yeah, the nice legendary.
Yeah.
Santa's village is in Finland. It has to be the reindeer.
It isn't. It is the brown bear.
Okay.
Yeah, we've been to Finland and you've yes. seen the reindeer running on the side of the road.
Yes,
we literally talked
creatures.
About they're like little twerpy deer and you want that. They get hit by cars. Like,
mm-hmm.
You know, that's like we were making jokes about how like why would you have like white-tailed deer as your animal yeah. and then you're like,
these
yeah,
are
reindeer.
Reindeer, like king of all deer.
They're not king of all deer. What is
not.
Wrong with you?
Yeah, definitely. They're not.
They're
not.
So tiny and stupid.
No, they're yeah. the reigning kings of all
that's
deer.
That's not what that means.
Yeah.
Oh, that's the wrong reign.
Okay.
Oh, God.
All right. So the combination of Zimbabwean zebra, of mm-hmm. course, is the incorrect one.
Okay.
Nice.
So Zimbabwe's national animal is the sable antelope.
Oh.
Okay.
Everything I said about the zebra is true.
Uh-huh.
That you hunt.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they do hunt the zebra in Zimbabwe.
They hunt wherever zebras are available in Africa, in all the countries, you can hunt.
Oh, wow.
Okay. So the sable antelope.
Yes.
Tell us about this. It's black, I'm assuming.
It's black. They're usually in herds and they like to be by themselves. But if you trouble them, then they will come attack you.
Oh,
oh yeah.
Yes.
They're so, like territorial sort
very
of.
Very territorial. Yes.
Mm.
And their horn, like very specific horn.
Okay.
Oh, whoa. It is a very majestic beast. Its horns go.
They go back.
They're big and long and they go back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
That's how they attack if you go travel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
So that's a good national animal.
They sound
that's
pretty
like
cool.
Majestic, not torpy like a reindeer.
I don't know. Wow. I should have known.
Yeah, I should have known. Thanks for listening to this episode of I Should Have Known. We're continuing our exploration of the animal kingdom. Next week, Tanner is going to be presenting you with 4 more endangered animals. So it's a part 2 kind of sequel, if you will. And as always, thanks for listening!